Students, in this video we will discuss another topic, culture methods. Why culture methods, or what is the need of culturing microorganisms? Because microorganisms are living as mixed populations, not as a single organism. In their natural habitat, microbes live as mixed populations. So, to study a particular bacterial species or a particular microorganism, it is very difficult if that particular organism is separated from other groups of organisms. So, the separation is important for studying a particular species. By using appropriate medium, we can isolate a particular species by using suitable culture methods. So, isolation is very important for studying, for characterization, for understanding a microorganism. So, we have already studied the different media used for the isolation of different types of microorganisms. So, by using suitable medium, and by using suitable culture methods, we can successfully isolate a particular species. There are different culture methods are employed. The culture method employed depends upon the purpose for which it is intended. So we can culture a particular microorganism, or we can isolate a particular microorganism for various reasons. The main reason is to isolate bacteria from mixed populations for making them pure culture, that is pure culture isolation. Okay, pure culture means a particular group of organisms which are originated from a single bacteria or single bacterium. They are called pure culture. I will discuss later, okay, what is pure culture in detail. So, in another case, the isolation or culture is used to storing bacteria. After isolation or after separation from their natural habitat, we have to store them. For further study, we have to store the bacteria. For that, we have to use another culture method. Then we need different types of organism for making vaccines, for vaccine preparation, for obtaining antibiotics or separating or producing different types of antibiotics. Then for industrial purposes, for making different types of products like enzymes and other pharmaceutical compounds, and also for diagnostic purposes, that is for the identification of a particular disease, we have to isolate a particular organism. So the culture method depends on what is our requirement or what is our need, based on which we have various culture methods. The culture method employed depend upon the purpose for which they are intended. I have already mentioned. The methods of culture used in ordinary microbiology lab are streak culture method or streak plate culture method, lawn culture method, straw culture method, stamp culture method, pore plate culture method, spread plate culture method, liquid culture method, and also for cultivating anaerobic microorganisms, there are another anaerobic culture methods. So these are the different culture methods ordinarily or commonly used in our lab. They are streak plate culture method, lawn culture method, straw culture method, stamp culture method, pore plate culture method, spread plate culture method, liquid culture, and anaerobic culture methods. We will discuss one by one. So in this session, we discuss streak plate culture, and also lawn culture and straw culture, and also we will discuss stamp culture also in this video. First is streak plate culture. What is streak culture method? And this is the most commonly used method for the isolation of bacteria in pure culture. That is a culture containing only a single type of organism. What is pure culture? Pure culture is a culture containing only single type of organism. Okay, they are called pure culture. So for pure culture isolation, the most commonly employed or the routinely employed method is streak plate culture method, or streaking. Simply it is called streaking or streak plate culture method. For this, a platinum or nichrome loop is used. Okay, we need a loop for the streaking procedure. Here a platinum loop is recommended, but because of its high cost, nichrome loop is commonly used. In our lab, we are using nichrome loop. Here, the method is for the isolation of the pure culture, or isolating bacteria as single colonies on a suitable agar medium. Okay, the commonly used medium for the cultivation of microorganism or bacteria is agar medium. Okay. Agar, that is a nutrient agar, or different types of agar media are used. So here in this procedure for making a streak plate or doing a streak or for culturing microorganism by using a streak plate method, one loopful of the specimen is taken. Specimen is the sample. The sample may be anything that contains that particular organism. Okay, it may be a mixed culture, or it may be pure culture. Okay, anyway, we have a sample, maybe in a liquid solution, or a soil sample, or a water sample, or a food sample, or any sample. So from that, one loopful of the specimen is taken by a flame sterilized loop. We have studied in flames red hot sterilization. In that, I have mentioned what is flaming. Or red hot sterilization is used for sterilizing loops. So by using a flame sterilized loop, one loopful of the specimen is taken and is placed on the surface of a well dried agar plate. Okay, a well dried agar plate means you have to make agar medium, and then you have to pour into a suitable into a petri dish, and then you have to allow it to dry. After that only, you have to place one loopful of the specimen taken with a flame sterilized loop, and you have to place on this well dried agar medium. After that, it is the inoculum, it is called a primary inoculum. The first taken the sample, the first placed sample on the agar, it is called a primary, what is it called? Primary inoculum. From this primary, by using the same loop, that specimen is spread over a small area at the periphery. You have to spread a small area. You will study how to, in the third semester, you will study how to do this streaking. Everyone will study the streaking. Okay, so after placing the sample on a small area on the agar medium, it is spread over a small area at the periphery. Okay, the inoculum is then distributed thinly over the media by streaking it with the loop in a series of parallel lines in different segments of the agar surface. So after making spreading the sample over a small periphery, you have to sterilize the loop. Then by using the sterilized and then cool, you have to cool the loop, and then you have to drag the specimen in parallel lines. You have to draw 4 or 5 lines from the primary inoculum to the second segment. Okay, at the different segments of the agar surface. The loop should be flamed and cooled between the different sets of the streaks. Then after you have to make this type, that the 4 sets of the streak, after completing that, you have to incubate the culture, the streaked plate at 37 degrees Celsius overnight, or 24 to 18 hours or 18 to 24 hours. Okay, then on incubation, the growth may be confluent at the site of the origin inoculation, because at the origin inoculation, the number of the cells will be huge. So we won't get any separated growth. You'll get only a confluent growth at the site of original inoculation, but it becomes progressively thinner, and at the last sets of the streak, we will get well separated colonies. What are colonies? They are the clones of the cells originating from a single cell. That means when what the inoculum or the what we streak during streaking, the cells will get in the last cells of the streak, the cells will get maximum separated, and then during incubation, this well separated cells, single cells, will multiply and then produce what millions of the cells, and we can see the growth as a mass of the cells. They are called colonies or clones of the cells originated from a single cell. They are called colony or pure culture. So this, we will get this type of colonies at the final series of the streaks. Okay, we are doing different sets of the streaks at different segments of the agar plate, and we will get the single well separated colonies only at the end of the or end or the final series of the streaks. Okay, then there are different way, or there are but we can streak the organism in different ways. The streaking can be done in different ways. The commonly employed method is quadrant streaking. This is the most commonly method of streaking is quadrant streaking. Okay, in which streaks are done on four different segments of the plate. First I told that is the inoculum is spread or the what drawn at different segments. Here the streaking is done on four different segments of the plate. That's why we go to quadrant. Quadrant means four. Four sets of streaks are, or four different segments are utilized for the streaking purpose. Okay, then the other methods are radiant streak, continuous streak, and a T streak. Okay, I will show how we have to do this in the coming slide. The other methods are radiant streak, continuous streak, and T streak. And this is a method. You can see you have to flame sterilize the loop. Then you have to take with the in the step B, you have to take the sample by in this way, and then you have to place it over the agar surface. Okay, this is called the initial inoculum. Then the first, this is the initial inoculum, the primary inoculum. After that, from there you have to drag by using different lines, different at different area or to different different area of the agar plate. Okay, so like that you have to draw the lines in four different segments of the agar plate. So it is called a quadrant streak. First you have to make a primary inoculum, then you have to draw four or five lines to in this area, then from this also you have to draw four or five lines, then next you have to draw in this way. So we are utilizing four different segments of the agar surface. That's it's called a quadrant streak. Okay, so like this is the first, second, third, and then the last. After that, after incubation, we will get the colonies like this. Here you can see the primary inoculum, the first set of streaks. Here you cannot see any isolated colonies. Then the second line also you can't see any colonies. Then the third and fourth sets you can see what the isolation of single colonies. And this is called a colony. The small dots are called colonies. Okay, I think it's clear. So it's another representation of the streak. Okay, you have to streak in different. Okay, continuous streak. Okay, then this is the quadrant streak. First, second, third, and fourth. Okay, this is the typical quadrant streak. First is the primary inoculum. From this, you have to draw four or five lines. Here, only three lines are shown. Then, from two to three, you have to draw same four or five lines. Then, three to four, you have to draw four or five lines. Then, in this area, you can expect the development of colonies. Okay, in between three and four. Okay, so this is, you can see the colonies, how this the colonies appear in different. So here you can see two types of colonies. One is having this one and the other is having red colored. So we can isolate the organism. Suppose we need this red colored organism, we can isolate this one. It is very easy. Okay, here you can see two types of organism. So here we cannot isolate any what organism, because it's growth is confluent. So in the last set of streaks, you can see the well separated colonies. The colonies are well separated. These are the single cells. Single cell during incubation, the single cell will multiply and then produce millions of cells. They are called a colony. This is called a colony, a single colony. And this also is another colony. So we can isolate organism. Just taking this colony, we can separate. So the organisms are separated. Okay, I think it's clear now. Then we will discuss the next culture method, that is the lawn culture method. The lawn culture provides a uniform surface growth of the bacterium and is useful for bacteriophage typing and antibiotic sensitivity testing. So this is a simple method. There is no much technology or much practice for this, making this lawn culture. It is very simple to make a lawn. Lawn means uniform. Okay, lawn. We are making lawn in our garden. Lawn, that means uniform. This is a uniform. So here the culture is uniform. The organism is uniformly spread over a agar surface. So we will get a uniform growth on the agar surface. So large growth can be obtained on a, means a layer of growth is obtained on an agar surface. That is called a lawn culture. And for this lawn culture, we need a cotton swab or an L rod. So by which we can use, by which we can spread the organism from a liquid culture or from a solid culture, we can spread the organism uniformly over the area. So after incubation, we will get a uniform growth throughout the surface of the growth. That is called a lawn of bacteria, lawn culture. Okay, it is mainly used for bacteriophage typing. We will study what is bacteriophage typing later. So it is used for the typing, bacteriophage typing and antibiotic sensitivity testing. Sometimes in your examination, it may ask which is the method used for the antibiotic sensitivity testing. This is nothing but lawn culture method. Which culture method is used? That is, the lawn culture method is used. It may also be employed for obtaining large amount of growth. Suppose in some situations we need a huge amount of bacterial growth. For that we can depend on lawn culture method. Okay, so sometimes the question may be asked like this. What are the applications of lawn culture method? Here you can write, it is for the bacteriophage typing, it is for antibiotic sensitivity testing, for getting large growth of organism. Okay, like that you can list out the the use of this lawn culture method. The lawn culture is prepared by flooding the surface of an agar plate with a liquid culture or suspension of the bacterium for making a uniform lawn by using a cotton swab or by using a spreader, a simple L spreader, L glass spreader or plastic spreader. By use of the cotton swab, we can uniformly spread the culture throughout the surface. Okay, so here also mentioned alternatively, the surface of the plate may be inoculated by applying a swab soaked in bacterial culture. That already I told. Okay, how we can prepare a lawn culture. Okay, I think it is understood. So this is the method of making lawn culture. You can this is a spreader. This is a spreader. By using the spreader, you can spread uniformly over the culture is spreaded uniformly over the surface for getting a uniform growth. You can see this is an antibiotic sensitivity plate. You can see this is a uniform growth of bacteria. Okay, you can see that this is a growth, uniform growth. Okay, the antibiotic, you have to place the antibiotic over that. If the antibiotic is effective, will get a zone of inhibition. It is a zone of inhibition. Here the growth is inhibited. There is no growth because this is an antibiotic. It killed the bacteria. Okay, here what studied, what are antibiotics? So the antibiotics, this antibiotic is killed. Antibiotics killed the bacteria, so there is no growth around this. So we can see the effect, we can identify the effectiveness of the antibiotic by measuring the zone of diameter, zone of inhibition. It's called zone of inhibition. This we have, from this to this you have to measure the diameter, the diameter in centimeter or in millimeter, not in centimeter, millimeter. You have to measure. So like that we can identify whether the organism is sensitive to a particular antibiotic or resistant. Okay, this is lawn culture. This culture is a lawn culture, and the plate is an antibiotic sensitivity tested antibiotic sensitivity testing method. Okay, the next is straw culture method. A straw culture is made in tubes containing agar slopes or slant. It is called a slant. The agar is, when the agar is normally prepared in or made in petri dishes. If it is made in slant or in a culture tube in a slope position, it is called a slant, agar slant, and is employed for providing a pure growth of bacterium. Okay, and this is done by streaking the slant surface with the loop containing the bacteria. You have to take, you have to just touch the sample. A pure culture is just, I have already shown that the colonies, just touch the colonies with a flame sterilized loop, and then take the small amount of the culture and then streak on the surface of the slant. Okay, slant is made on in a tube. So on that surface, we will get a small surface in the slanted position. Then you have to streak on the surface. Okay, that method is called, the streaking on a slant is called a stalk culture method. And this method is employed for short-term storage of bacteria. Okay, after isolation we have to store. Okay, we cannot store the organism in the petri dishes itself for a long period, because it will get easily dried or destroyed. So we have to store them under suitable conditions. So the good method for short-term storage is by the stalk culture method, by streaking on a slant, and then we can after getting the proper growth, we have to place the tube in a sealing the tube, we have to place the tube in refrigerator, so we can store it for 2 or 3 months. So the application of stalk culture method is for a short-term storage of bacterial cultures. Okay. Then stab culture method. Okay, stab. What is meant by stab? Stabbing. Stab cultures are prepared by puncturing a medium. You have to puncture a medium, such as a nutrient gelatin or glucose agar, with a long straight charged wire. Charged means when the organism is at the tip of the loop or a wire, it is called a charged wire or loop. Wire means when the loop is cut, it's a needle, a pointed portion. When the loop is cut, then the loop portion is cut, round portion is cut, it is called a wire. So, or a needle. So by using a needle or taking a small amount of colony, and then after that it is that is called a charged wire. By using this charged wire, you have to puncture a medium such as a nutrient gelatin or glucose agar that is made in a tube. The previous, that is stalk culture, you are streaking on a slant. Here a small amount of the agar is poured, and then it is allowed to settle or allowed to solidify in the upright position. So you will get a butt. Okay, that is called a butt, agar butt. So this, by using this charged straight wire, we have to puncture the medium. Okay, then after that, the medium is allowed to sit with the tubes, or that is making, that's the procedure for making the, how we can make what an agar butt. Not agar slant, agar butt. Here the medium is allowed to sit with the tubes are in upright position. And this will provide a flat surface at the top of the medium. Okay, just pour the small amount of medium into a tube. And then allow it to sit in the upright position. So we'll get a straight surface at the top of the medium. We'll get a straight surface, not a slanted. When the tube is placed in slanted position, we'll get a slant. If it is placed in an upright position, so we'll get a flat surface. Then this medium is then inoculated by stabbing with a charged wire. So from the top you have to stab by using a charged wire. The stab culture is here. The stab culture is employed for demonstration of gelatin liquefaction. There is a biochemical test for identifying microorganisms, bacteria, that is called gelatin liquefaction. The method used is stab culture method, and also for oxygen requirement of the bacterium under study, whether the organism is requiring oxygen, whether they are microaerophilic or they are anaerobic or they are obligate aerobe, we can do by using stab culture method. Okay. And there, this stab culture method is also used for short-term maintenance of the stock culture. What is in a stock culture means? Once the organism is isolated and placed in, we are isolated, that's called a stock culture for storing. For further study, we have to store the organism. That's called a stock culture. For stock culture maintenance also, this method is employed. So this method is employed for gelatin liquefaction, oxygen requirement of the bacterium, and also for short-term maintenance of stock culture. Okay, that's all about this stab culture method. So in this video we have, or in this session we have studied four different methods of culture. That is, the most important is streak plate culture, and then next is lawn culture method, and the third is stock culture method, and the fourth is stab culture method.